Good afternoon. This is a song. Rob Ellis here. This is a song that I initially wrote in 1981 with the title Tenderness, Trust, Friendship, Future. It morphed over time into the choral part of the first symphony, my first symphony, which was completed in 1985, December 13th. It's to become the final choral utterance of the fourth movement of the symphony number one in D major, the last movement being in C minor. And then the chorus comes in at the very end and sings this piece, which I composed as a melody many years before, in around 1980-81, and then decided to put a lyric to it. So it doesn't mimic, but it's the opposite idea of Beethoven's ninth, where it ends joyously and jubilee. My first symphony ends in a minor key, sort of sorrowfully. It's the opposite feeling. It's a feeling of angst, a feeling of hope for the future. Because we live in a different age today than Beethoven did, so this is looking out at the world. Now, this first symphony I completed in 1985, my last symphony I finished, number nine, May 11th, 2005, before Christina and I got wedded in Camp Meeker. Now, the 10th symphony is going to be a totally different concept of a symphony, and therefore I'm not jinxing myself. A lot of composers don't finish their 10th, but this is going to be a totally different, an array of notes in a way that I'm not going to tell what it's about, but it's going to be different. I'm planning it to take 30 years, so hopefully it'll be performed in 2053 AD, and it's going to take a while to amass, to put together. Just I'm taking my time with it. Anyway, this one is the choral theme from the first symphony, which is in D major, and quite lively, and has improvisations on it, and it has an hour-long chant that of 7th, 8th century monks on stage chanting a societal commentary in Gregorian chant style on the 20th century, and they're holding cats, because cats, they're in history, gave their guts to the orchestra. The cat gut was actually some of the ingredients in violin strings. So it's a homage to the unselfishness of the cats, who emanate from the Sirius complex, the sixth dimensional star Sirius. All the pharaohs in Egypt were communicated with cats. Cats were highly revered in Egypt in 10,000 BC. When the pyramids were finished with sound levitation, and where the astrologers and astronomers talked back and forth on equal terms and understood many mysteries of the universe that were too cynical to understand in this age. Anyway, this piece is called, it's not called Tenderness, Trust, Friendship, Future. It's just it's the ending, it's an ending theme of the last movement. I'm not sure what the title is. Anyway, here we go. Hopefully I can get it done in one take.
Adores peace.
peace on earth, cross heaven's girth, gives a human kind infinite worth. Galactic wonder has begun, joyously ecstatic in ascending fun on new day one forever one, and the futurous sky of an ending light, fragrant wind that sings so new of cosmic night, all souls delight. Takes flight, and the fear of war is now no more, and the angels singing heavenly to cease and fears release, and all human at end peace. Now here's where that oboe solo comes in. The end of the first symphony. It's about a 3.5-hour work. It starts with the monks chanting 111-page recitative and Gregorian chant, making sort of a cauteristic cauterize caustic commentary on the 20th century and a lot of the ills of the age, and makes fun of rock music and the electronic industry, which is totally different from classical music. It's from the constellation Orion. Classical music is from the Pleiades. They're separated by many, many light years. So to conflate music is number one error on this planet. Music is a subtle art form, and it's very unique. Each style of music is different. Otherwise, you're never going to achieve the fifth dimensional perception if you conflate everything. You're just reducing things to simplistic perception, which is not, there's no way to get to enlightenment that way. Anyway, enjoy, and thank you, and it was okay. Maybe I'll have another version.